Well, when you're looking for a car, you depend on reliability, durability, speed, safety, and whatnot. However, the favorite of all, Toyota's RAV4, may lose its power to rule the automobile industry. Why is that? Moving forward, what is happening exactly? What is the issue? And are other companies also facing the same problem? You're watching Tech Addicts, your only place for authentic information. So without any further delay, let's quickly get down to the video. One of the more impressive plug-in hybrid vehicles that we've tried is Toyota's RAV4 Prime. Its 18.1 kilowatt-hour lithium-ion battery provides it with a reliable electric-only range of approximately 40 miles, and its extremely efficient Atkinson cycle engine ensures that it achieves more than 40 miles per gallon even when the battery is completely depleted. However, owners of RAV4 Primes manufactured in 2021 will need to make a service appointment soon. In the most recent wave of car recalls, which affected over 131,000 vehicles this week, the problems that led to the recalls were software glitches, missing parts, and parts that were incorrectly constructed. Recalls were issued by Honda, Toyota, and General Motors. You can also check the vehicle recall database maintained by USA Today or search the database maintained by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration of the United States. Your vehicle's identification number can be used to conduct a search on the NHTSA website to see whether or not your automobile is subject to a recall. You can also get additional information by getting in touch with the manufacturer of your vehicle. Due to a problem with the rear view camera, Honda's recalling 114,000 vehicles. According to a report by the NHTSA, Honda recalled an additional 114,686 Fit and HRV models because the display may fail to boot up, preventing it from presenting the video image from the backup camera. Vehicles that could be affected are the 2018 to 2020 Honda Fit hatchback and the 2019 through 2022 Honda HRV SUV. Honda stated in its communication with the NHTSA that the recall only applied to vehicles with key ignition. The Japanese automobile manufacturer stated in its report that the display circuit was created in an inappropriate manner. According to the report, there are instances in which the display unit is unable to start up when the car is started because the cranking of the engine causes the battery level in the car to drop. Since 2018, Honda has received over 200 warranty claims on the issue. However, the company has not received any reports of injuries or fatalities as a result of the problem. According to the report, owners will be informed of the recall on March 13th, and they will be instructed to take their vehicles to an authorized Honda dealer so that a software update may be installed. It's also possible that the Toyota hybrid RAV4 will lose power when driven at high speeds. According to a report by the NHTSA, Toyota has decided to recall 16,679 hybrid RAV4 SUVs because faulty software might cause the vehicle's motor to suddenly lose power, which would increase the likelihood of a collision. Vehicles that could be affected include the 2021 Toyota RAV4 Prime. Yes, you heard right. According to Toyota's statement in the report, the problem is limited to RAV4 Prime SUVs that are equipped with a control unit that has been improperly programmed. When it comes to the electrified powertrains of the Toyota RAV4, another problem with their dependability has been discovered. This time, the issue is not the premature or unanticipated corrosion of a high-voltage cable. Rather, it is the potential for the wire to stall when exposed to cold weather. When driving in EV mode at low temperatures, a rapid acceleration in some RAV4 Prime models may cause an abrupt reduction in battery voltage. This may occur when the vehicle is driven in EV mode. If this occurs, a warning message will appear on the instrument panel and the hybrid system will immediately shut down, resulting in an abrupt loss of power to the wheels. It would appear that the first incident was reported in Europe in March of the previous year, and that this was followed by at least five further incidents on this side of the Atlantic. The electronic control unit of the hybrid system is at fault. In light of the increased likelihood of a collision, especially when traveling at high speeds, Toyota will initiate a recall of about 21,000 vehicles in North America, including 4,545 in Canada. To be clear, this only applies to the 2021 model year of the RAV4 Prime. In the coming weeks, the car maker will tell owners of their vehicles by sending them a letter in the mail. However, a select few owners have already been informed by their dealer and have made an appointment. The control ECU of the hybrid system will need a software upgrade to be fixed. Back to Cablegate. We reported in late December that Toyota Canada was extending its warranty to cover the high voltage cable that connects the rear electric motor to the vehicle for an additional 8 years or 160,000 kilometers, whichever comes first, on select RAV4 hybrid models manufactured between 2019 and 2022. Therefore, in the event that severe corrosion is discovered and verified by a Toyota dealer, the customer will not be responsible for any costs associated with the vehicle's repair. A class action lawsuit was initiated in Quebec in 2017, since a safety recall has not been issued yet, and that numerous RAV4 hybrid owners have had to pay thousands of dollars to fix their vehicles after the initial warranty of 3 years or 60,000 kilometers has expired. There is also a petition on change.org that is still being circulated to exert additional pressure on Toyota. According to the report, the battery voltage may drop too low levels and display warning message before the hybrid system shuts down if the vehicle is rapidly accelerated in cold temperatures after being driven continuously in electric vehicle mode. According to the research, this would lead to an abrupt loss of power which might cause the vehicle to crash. According to the report, Toyota intends to notify owners between the dates of February 27th and April 3rd. At no additional cost, a software update will be made available at Toyota dealerships. There is a possibility that some GM automobiles with missing or faulty parts could roll away. Because of a potential for rollaway and collision, General Motors is recalling 20 cars across the Cadillac, Chevrolet, and GMC brands. Vehicles that could be affected are 2023 Chevrolet Blazer, the 2023 Chevrolet Traverse, the 2023 Cadillac XT5, and the 2023 GMC Acadia. According to GM's statement and a report submitted to the NHTSA, the automaker has found 10 Chevrolet Blazer and Traverse vehicles that are missing an assembly ring from the left-hand half-shaft assembly. According to the research, the absence of the components may result in the inner half-shaft joint becoming disengaged from the shaft itself. In a separate report submitted to the NHTSA, General Motors stated that the recalled Cadillac and GMC cars both have right-hand assembly shafts that may become disconnected from the transmission due to a manufacturing fault on the part of a supplier. According to the research, each of these problems could result in the vehicles losing its ability to move forward or prohibit it from being parked mechanically. GM has stated that it will inform owners about the recall on March 24th and will provide free replacements for shaft assemblies. Toyota's former president, Akio Toyoda, announced that the corporation would transition from an automaker to a mobility company during the Consumer Electronics Show in January 2018. To that end, Toyota and SoftBank, a corporation with an emphasis on AI development, partnered to form Monet Technologies Corporation, a next-generation mobility services firm that has funding from and partnerships with companies like Uber and Grab. Toyota's Woven City project at Mount Fuji Space will be its finest achievement as it gradually transforms into a mobility corporation. A community of researchers and developers will set up permanent residence in this living laboratory to conduct field tests of cutting-edge technologies like autonomous vehicles, robotics, personal mobility, and smart homes, all while benefiting from the grid's decentralized renewable energy provided by hydrogen fuel cells. And make no mistake, as spectacular as it may sound, it is. However, the Toyota Group, which naturally includes Lexus, is an automobile manufacturer and makes revenue from the sale of automobiles. Even though it is investing hundreds of millions of dollars in Woven City, the company's primary focus will remain on developing cutting-edge automobiles and sport utility vehicles. And here are Toyota's four primary strategies for the next 3 years. Goal number one is to increase the variety of SUVs on the market. Goal number two is to develop and refine hybrids. Goal number three is to introduce sports cars. And goal number four is to develop and increase the use of electric vehicles. Since the debut of the first Toyota Prius more than 24 years ago, the company has accumulated a wealth of hybrid expertise that it plans to put to use in developing its next generation of sport vehicles. A next-generation hybrid-powered GT86 Coupe, for instance, may debut as soon as next spring. The next Lexus ISF, and a 660-horsepower LSF, as well as a new Corolla Sports GRMN, or short for Gazoo Racing Meister of Nürburgring, will have the hybrid technology in 2022, while the Toyota Group's also preparing a GR Hypersports and Supra GRMN for 2023. Toyota may have been slow to the electric vehicle party, but the company plans to make up for lost time over the next few years, beginning with the unveiling of an EV SUV concept at this year's Tokyo Motor Show. Even though Woven City is where much of Toyota's work on autonomous EV technology will be done, the corporation will continue to focus on making automobiles through its other businesses. There is no room for doubt there. To touch the perfection, Toyota is working hard, and so are the other companies. That's all we have for the video today. If you want to watch more such videos, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel, and thanks for watching.